Hello, everybody. This is Crystal Master 4 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Bayonetta 2. In the last episode, we traveled into the sky and fought a bunch of angels in heaven, merely, and only to be brought back down to square one, where we're on our way to find out where the crap Loki is and why he ran into Luca. And what the crap all this is about with that weird character, that masked character that we saw, who really doesn't like to be subtle at all. So in this episode, we're gonna go into this door and get it exploded. Never mind. Also, be sure you dodge there, because then you get free wish time. So we also got the Kefka gun. You know, that's what I call it. Oh, I thought I dodged it right. Here we go. Oh my god! I haven't seen that one. Yeah. Like, you're gonna... Nope. Yeah, no, you're not gonna get me on your wind-up attack that just hits like a wind-up. As opposed to a wind-up attack that doesn't hit like a wind-up. Oh, yeah, see? You can get away from me, you cannot! Cause I'm gonna murder you senseless, as every single character does in this game. That's it with that. And now, since the moon's out of our sight, we cannot use our magical powers or whatever anymore. So the frame rate's gonna kinda dip for a bit before we go through this door like a senseless person. Or sensible person. I don't know. Take your pick. Let's go over here. Get this invincibility lollipop that I apparently never got before. Because again, racing back here. Kind of did skip some things. So if I remember correctly, yeah. So this is going to lead to a really amazing scene.
No time. I have to get to Fimble Venture.
So please just enjoy this.
Why do I have to go there? What is on the mountain? Ugh. My head feels like it's going to burst. I have to get to that mountain! Shit! What was that? Nice mask, mate. Headed to that witch's party. Not the best costume I've ever seen, but she doesn't seem like the picky type. Just don't get in my way.
Where is she?
So you are going to her party. Quite the popular one, isn't she? Sorry, mate, but I haven't the fucking slightest. Haven't seen her in ages. Besides, even if I knew, she and I have a special relationship.
Then this will be all the easier.
So we're in a hurry, as I waited for a split second to do anything. So we're still in a hurry, guys. We gotta get to Loki. We gotta get to him real quickly. It's of the utmost importance and urgency. He might die.
I
again, he might die. There could be nothing left to stop this mastermind from killing what our only lead is to get to where we need to go. He might be dead. Here's the other half of the LP, by the way. I never found this on my first playthrough. Like, my very first playthrough. Not for the Let's Play. This is like my first time playing. Then there's like a mini. If I didn't get hit, that would have been a pure platinum. I would have been so happy. So, look at this slug. Look at this slug that's happening. Again, we have no time. We have no time to save Loki. So, look at this relationship people are having. Let's ruin it. And now they're running for their life. But hey, we got more angels to fight, don't we? Come on, attack me. There we go. Think you can outsmart me? Oh, yeah. You're gonna be dead, bruh. Especially when I hold down the weapon and show what it can really do. You are dead. I overkilled you for that. You better be glad that I overkilled you for that. So yeah, Rodan's thing was like locked as well. Oh, I probably should have used these. These are better. So let's go down to Rodan's place and collect our new weapon. I'm sure it'll be useful in the upcoming fight. It's also one that I never caught before on my very first time playing. So, that's a shock.
Another LP. No rest for the wicked. Even if I am jollier than the average demon. But no need to pity me. I was bored anyways. Be right back. This one's gonna be fun. Been looking for a workout like this for a while. Ta-ta. Done and done. I like it when they come quiet-like. Means they still have some fight left in them for the road ahead. He's all yours now, Bayonetta.
The Undyne. So, to use this weapon, I just put a bunch of fish to my hands and feet. So what I'm going to do, actually, is buy this. And can't buy this yet, but I will later. The Undyne, first time playing through it in, you know, the broken file, as I will now call it. What else? Did I get anything else? Yeah, no, the broken file. It basically, you'll see. I'll show it off. It's slow, but it's interesting. But no, like I said, we're in a hurry. We need to be there as quick and as swiftly as possible. Guys, meet one of the most awesome things in this game. Bayonetta to the rescue!
You! What kind
of adult picks on little children?
I'm not a child!
A mask? Let me guess. This is one of your assistants, little one?
Nothing comes to mind, love. Sorry. Maybe you've got something you'd like to tell me, love. I'm not a fan of getting wrapped up in domestic disputes.
Trust me, little one. He's not my type.
Gotta have that flair.
Oh my. You're a Lumen Sage.
AKA the most overpowered thing ever. But specifically, you mean the Masked Lumen. So this is a boss fight. Now you might be thinking to yourself right now, like, oh, this is just seems like a really cool boss fight just on its own. Like a really by-the-numbers boss fight, just like from the last game. Oh, trust me, it'll get better later on. But basically, the point of this fight is that you're basically fighting against what would be your equal. Oh, Jesus Christ. And yeah, he attacks really quickly. He attacks really quickly and does a lot of unpredictable stuff. So, have your hand at the ready to, you know, use your wish time. Actually, wait a second. I should have my swords. So basically what the Undyne does is whenever you spin, it switches between fire and ice. Here we go. Here's the best part of this fight. So he summons Fortuo from the first game. And we summon our Gecko. And this whole boss battle happens in the background. And you're gonna wanna hit him when he does this! So that he doesn't summon the boss to fight for. So yeah, the Undying basically is like a fire and ice weapon that you switch between via spinning. The Undyne is really super slow too. You know, this boss fight is really freaking cool. You have a really high stakes boss battle with a really high stakes boss battle in the background. Nope. Fortuo is dead, and so is our game. Then we summon Madame Butterfly herself. And then he summons this ugly thing from the first game. And they duke it out while we're battling in the sky. Come on! You cannot tell me that this is not an amazing fight. I'm getting my ass handed to me right now. Yeah, no, I'm gonna switch back to the guns. The cut that out again. The Undyne is not the best weapon to fight now. Also, yeah, there's certain ones you can't actually run away. But no, this is a combo I used for a long time in the game. And I definitely used it in the other Let's Play. It's actually really good. Come on! No! You're not getting that guy to fight me. No matter if it's on your life. I thought I dodged that, but I guess I didn't. Just look at this. The camera angles are amazing. I'm really getting beaten too much. Here we go. Okay, stop. Oh, no you don't. No, you don't. Nope. Aww. Yeah, stop it. And now we're fighting as Madam Butterfly. Dodge it to get into witch time. Get some uppercuts in. Then fucking do it! Dragon Ball Z fighting. Yeah, that was terrible. I kept getting hit. Anyway, that was the two meat. Because of course. Get some reverse cake. So yeah, that was a video. Just to showcase how really amazing this game is. So, in the next episode of Let's Play Bayonetta 2, we're gonna go to the Cathedral of Cascades. See you guys next time.